Tor's in the wellness center, isn't he?
No, he's... Well, yes, but you really shouldn't go in there right now.
I'm gonna need you to unlock the door. This is FBI business.
It's just... There's some things that, Yes, okay. I'll let you in.
Thank you, Rose.
Odin said Tor needs help. But from what? Is he turning into a Taken?
Watch out.
For puddles. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
Right. Thanks.
That lady is a walking red flag.
I need bolt cutters. Be ready, Saga. Hello? Tor? It's Saga Anderson.
Saga realized the crossbow could hold two shots at the same time. Had she just not noticed before? Or had the weapon changed somehow? Like in a dream? Saga strained to pull the string of the crossbow back as far as she could. To her surprise, the latch adjusted to accommodate her. The next bolt would stop a monster. In one fluid motion, Saga cracked open the shotgun, sending the empty hulls flying over her shoulder, and slammed the new shells in faster than she had imagined possible. Poor Anderson had lightning in his veins. This was rock and roll, baby. That Weaver girl had cast a spell on him. Tor would do anything she'd ask. Tor deserved this. Tor wanted this. She wanted the song. A gift. He had to get it for her. Afterwards, it was too late. Tor swung his hammer in frustration. The spark was gone. Black liquid clogged his mind. A bad trip. Tor fought it. He was strong. He'd never be taken. But the darkness could still drown him. Tor needed to warn someone. It was all happening again. Tom was back. Coming back. Tom would need help too if he was going to make it. But the brothers were too old to stop at this time. Tor had called someone. Someone who could help. The name escaped him. Drowned beneath dark water.
Tor is being targeted. He needs help. Tor was here. He's hurt pretty bad, but he tore off his bandages. Why? Must be locked from the other side.
It's me!
Tor left the wellness center.
security computer. Ugh, this door needs a knob. Day, then month. He uses European formatting. The Koskala brothers aren't just in the cult. They're its damn leaders. Needs a password. And a warrant.
technically. But hey, desperate times.
Odin is sleeping upstairs, but your grandpa's been acting crazy.
I have what I need to figure out the password. An electric lock. Looks like it's controlled remotely.
There's Tor. And he's out of his mind. Need to get to him. And the doors are open.
Ilmo was nervous. His palms were clammy. He lowered his phone. Mulligan isn't picking up. Yako shook his head, pointed at his own phone. Same with Thornton. Ilmo didn't like it. No one was answering the phone at the workshop in Watery either. Something was up. It had to be the writer. Had to be. The Koskula brothers were crouching in the bushes across from the Elderwood Palace Lodge, its light shining in the night. They couldn't wait any longer. The brothers knew Saga was in Watery visiting her trailer. Going now was their only chance to do this without hurting her. Ilmo stood up in a crowd of deer masks, looked his way. Okay, this is it. The rider is the target. Take him down and it's all over. Only shoot the Fed if you have to. This is our big moment. We watch in the night. The crowd murmured the chant back to him. Ilmo turned his face to the hotel. He could see Saga's partner in the window. Ilmo slapped his brother on the shoulder. The brothers donned their masks. The cult of the tree was ready.
Hi there, little friend.
Saga fired the rifle, hit the Taken again, pulled back the bolt to reload. She fired again, another hit, faster, again, yet faster, again. A strange, lethal feedback loop forming, speeding up.
Two remaining.
Gail Barrows stared at his chest x-ray. It was in his left lung. It felt like a black hole, an opening to darkness. He felt like he was drowning. He coughed and coughed and coughed. So hard his whole body and soul felt twisted and mangled, upside down and inside out. With every cough, the black hole grew bigger. It felt good. It tore him up, but it felt good. Gail was dying. The black hole was sucking everything good out of him. He imagined looking through it, into the darkness. The black hole grinned. Gail couldn't escape its gravity. He worshipped it. Gail sacrificed to it. In blood.
Rustic!
good. Need to catch up with Tor. This must have been Tor's.
This minute! That water is bad for you! Tor, wait!
Oh.
Cynthia Weaver, I know it's you! This kind of behavior is not okay!